Then how does port call optimization work? Port call optimization is a concept that is rapidly growing in popularity around the world. By continuously working to improve the efficiency of vessel port stays, it is possible to improve safety, reduce cost, and reduce emissions. In the majority of port calls conducted around the world, significant waiting times for vessels mean that fuel is needlessly burned to compensate. Port call optimization is the process by which new business models, technologies, and operational techniques are developed and implemented to reduce those vessel waiting times to zero. For every hour a ship remains idle in port, it loses an hour of steaming time and therefore must sail faster to maintain its schedule. While the speed difference may be marginal, it typically has a huge impact on a vessel's fuel consumption. According to the IMO, a 10% reduction in speed can lead to a 30% reduction in fuel consumption and emissions. Analysis conducted by the EU-funded Sea Traffic Management Validation Project discovered that in 2017, container ships incurred 71,202 hours of idle time at Europe's major ocean-going ports. This represents an annual loss of 100 million euros just to the container sector only. Port call optimization is one of the measures being developed to help the industry reach the IMO's target of a 50% reduction in GHG emissions from 2008 levels by 2050. Port call optimization in an era of supply chain upheaval. In 2019, when the first guide to port call optimization was launched, the pre-COVID shipping industry was dealing with the typical challenges of an experienced global industry. Trade tariff tensions between China and the United States in 2019 raised trans-Pacific freight rates, while the upcoming 2020 IMO sulfur regulations meant that shipyard utilization was at record levels as ship operators strived to install scrubbers and hedge against increased bunker prices. Long-standing geopolitical tensions ignited in the Straits of Hormuz as multiple tankers and merchant ships were seized or damaged, raising insurance premiums and the nerves of crew and ship operators in the area. Tariffs and the political tensions would pale in significance with the outbreak of COVID-19. A localized outbreak in December 2019 became an epidemic and then a global pandemic. The shipping industry has been at the forefront of the crisis, dealing with primary and secondary effects of COVID ever since January 2020. With nations reeling from economic turmoil, the shipping companies have acted fast to remain viable. From idle vessels and premature vessel demolitions to the crewing crisis to local and national lockdowns, followed rapidly by the economic recovery, with supply chain demand rocketing, causing proportionate rises in freight and charter rates and port congestion. The last years in shipping have been wild. The wild ride continues with shipping companies eager to recoup their COVID losses, build up their reserves, and manage the record levels of demand. As nations and economies recover, shipping companies are making record profits, but the industry also has some way to go to be considered back to normal. The 2021 Guide to Port Call Optimization looks at the aforementioned topics in greater detail, together with a range of case studies from companies, creating opportunities for shore-based cargo operations monitoring, just-in-time shipping, collaborative data sharing, advanced artificial intelligence usage, cargo forecasting, and turning weather forecasts into actionable insights. We believe that above all else, the sustainability of our industry is key, and to ensure that, we must actively seek our ways to support and collaborate with each other, which is the sole purpose of the guide. To further understand how port call optimization has become increasingly relevant this year, we need to look back at the events of 2019. With China shutting down factory production and enforcing national lockdowns to prevent the early spread of COVID-19, vessels were arriving in Europe and the United States with import cargo and rushing to fill export cargo slots. Full containers were prioritized over empties, with ship operators mindful of boosting short-term revenue in preparation for an unpredictable short-term future. This demand led to difficulties once China started opening up. A lack of empty containers in the Far East and a glut of loaded containers long waited for export put pressure on both ports and operators alike. Shipping companies were quick to react. At ever-increasing rates, carriers chartered additional tonnage and even recalled vessels that were destined for the scrapyard only a few months earlier. As they did so, it was inevitable that the time needed for vessels to ease pressure on routes would mean cargo owners faced increasing spot rates and more rollovers and cancellations. Slot cancellations added to the increasing demurrage and detention charges, and cargo owners started looking for alternative means of securing their own supply chain. Feeders, general cargo ships, and almost any vessel capable of carrying containers were now tasked on intercontinental voyages to shift the reliance from the major carriers. As COVID-19 required universal national economic and policy triage, port congestion has been a consistent theme since January 2020. Even as COVID-related lockdowns took hold, the cargo need remained high enough for shipping to continue. Items relating to personal protective equipment, PPE, and chemicals such as disinfectants and sanitizers were essential to prevent the spread. As more people were confined to their homes, finished goods were also sought after. And of course, the world had a front row seat to ever given crisis, which created a ripple effect of congestion that spread around the globe, causing an already overburdened supply chain to all but implode. The current high charter rates are worrying for liners who rely heavily on charter vessels. With increased rates for smaller vessels, the length of the charter is also increasing as a result of the competition for vessels. Vessels chartered at today's rates may make for painful costs with certain liners if the freight rates fall considerably by 2023 to 2024. Freight rates continue to match the charter rate trend and are still at all-time highs. Globally, freight rates are up over 300% on 2020 levels, with the Asia-North Europe trade currently posting a 569% year-on-year growth with little signs of abatement. Most analysis also expect the current trend is set to remain the same at least into this year. As the year draws to a close and the next major industry milestone of Chinese New Year following shortly after, high rates and significant port congestion showed little sign of easing. As an example, the Port of Los Angeles and Long Beach started 2021 with 31 container ships at anchor per day awaiting a berth. The number dropped to a low of 10 ships in June and has risen ever since, hitting a maximum of 70 container ships in September. The impact was not just felt in Southern California, with the port congestion spreading to the other major U.S. West Coast, ports of Seattle, Tacoma, Oakland, and further north in Vancouver and Prince Rupert. It took 6 months to reduce the number of waiting container ships by 2/3. To do the same for 70 vessels is going to take considerably longer. It is possible to clear congested ports, but it does take a considerable effort. The port congestion in Yantian started in late May 2021 due to an outbreak of COVID amongst its workforce. By June 21, there were 50 ships waiting for operations, down from a maximum of approximately 70 ships a week earlier. By July 6, the port was running at near normal levels, and the congestion incident was considered resolved by major carriers, even though secondary effects meant that nearby ports of Sheko and Nansha were impacted too. With port congestion comes reducing schedule reliability by carriers. This impact is directly felt by the cargo owners, and they are starting to take matters into their own hands to secure cargo space. Large retailers such as IKEA and Walmart are chartering vessels to control their own cargo destiny. Whilst this trend of private chartering may be a flash in the pan, it is still a concern for many shipping companies who are already battling with the pressures of reducing fuel consumption and meeting emissions targets. The multitude of issues today will not disappear overnight. As an industry, we need to take proactive measures to recover and prosper. The 2021 Guide to Port Coal Optimization explores solutions to help combat each of the challenges earlier mentioned, and many provide opportunities for immediate return on investment, increased efficiencies, and the ever-important reduction in fuel. Potential impact of a JIT arrival solution. For the vessel owners and operators, JIT arrivals reduce significantly both fuel consumption and emissions during the voyage by optimizing the vessel's speed to meet the expected arrival time, eliminate the time waiting at anchor for port access, thereby eliminating wasted fuel consumption and associated emissions while maintaining the basic power needs of the vessel, increase navigational safety, improve rest hours planning for the ship's crew and nautical services. Slow steaming for just-in-time arrivals has been simulated based on real operation profiles using Automatic Identification System AIS data. by reacting promptly to the time of arrival recommendations with a notification period of 24 hours before the actual arrival at berth, average fuel savings of up to 10% were achieved. However, since variations are big, the potential for individual voyage savings can be as much as 50%. For ports and terminals, JIT arrivals reduce congestion around the port area, increase safety because of fewer vessels around the port area, reduce local area emissions due to decreased anchorage time, create better visibility for coming operations via digitally shared estimated arrival times ETAs for incoming vessels, and the possibility to communicate changed recommended arrival times RTAs digitally. This enables better and more efficient planning of operations within the port community. Port call optimization, two sides of the same coin. In recent years, a strong emphasis has been put upon port call optimization to facilitate just-in-time shipping. Diverse initiatives to standardize processes and communications conducted within the port, with visiting ships and with previous and next ports. Not surprisingly, ports and terminals have led this development to enhance their value proposition. Once core value coming out of port call optimization is enhanced, predictability, which is an important foundation for shipping lines scheduling and planning processes. Predictability in a ship's arrival to the port is at the same time an important foundation for expanding the planning horizon for ports moving towards a commitment-driven planning process rather than continuing to follow the first-come, first-served principle. However, port call optimization needs to be regarded from different business logics. A port-centric approach raises the concern of the port with its operators to optimize the utilization of their resources, while a ship-centric approach raises the concern of ensuring high utilization of the ship paying visit to multiple ports. Container shipping tends to operate a port rotation schema, where the rotation through successive ports needs to be taken into consideration for the shipping line. It is not enough to just explore the concern of ensuring high utilization of the ship paying visit to multiple ports. Why is port call optimization on the IMO agenda? Increasing demands are being made to overcome the fact that many of the world's ports continue to serve ships on a first-come, first-served basis, causing inefficiencies and an adverse carbon footprint. This port business logic has caused a lot of concern associated with just-in-time shipping, and as a result, increasing the synchronization between the ship's plan for arriving to the port and the port's capabilities of serving the ship is now high on the IMO agenda and is now a component in how digitalization is recommended to be adopted for the world's ports. Just-in-time shipping is conceived as one of the toughest initiatives to realize, but also one of the initiatives that would have most impact on improving both the sustainability and the image of shipping transport. This is also one of the parts where capital productivity from the involved actors has a direct relationship to energy efficiency. Port call optimization is now being actively promoted by organizations such as the Digital Container Shipping Association. As a standardized approach to port visit interaction and the foundation for optimal turnaround times. Particular emphasis is put upon container shipping and on the need to take the container line rotation schedule into consideration, because disruptions occurring at one port causes accumulated delays to succeeding ports. Delays in previous ports may cause a ship needing to steam faster and burn more fuel to meet an original time slot, thereby reducing returns on capital productivity and energy efficiency, or to cut and run or even skip a visit to a port part in the rotation schedule, thereby presenting a lesser quality of transport service to clients, or risk waiting in the next port and thereby reduce the optimization of the ship asset when it becomes idle. It is also important to take a wide perspective on a global airport. A port-centric perspective on port call optimization. A port is concerned with optimizing its utilization of resources and infrastructure, serving multiple visits made by different shipping companies simultaneously. The average port serves different types of trade, such as container tariff, traffic, wet and dry bulk, regular and cruise-based passenger transport, etc., all driven by different business logics. Container calls are part of a larger schedule with multiple visits to the same port. A single cruise call is planned maybe 2 years ahead of time. Regular passenger traffic is often repetitive, and bulk ships are highly dependent on supply and demand driven by market prices for the cargo. For the port to overcome the challenges of meeting the needs for different types of trade, two complementary approaches are taken: to seek as much flexibility on replanning at the last minute, and to expand the planning horizons as much as possible. The latest developments at the top of the data analytics agenda of maritime informatics, access to data streams, and enhanced digital connectivity across the ecosystem of maritime transport are all expected to support such ambitions. Unfortunately, it seems that many ports are slow to digitalize. Now, this, in turn, affects the opportunities to harvest the data now coming out of smart containers, something that could only help ports to shorten container dwell time in terminals and support vessel planners in adjusting their storage plans. Initiatives to standardize the core definitions used as coordination mechanisms, such as the meaning of an estimated time of arrival to a particular location in the port call process, as well as the standardizing processes of interaction between the involved actors, have already been taken. One may, however, raise some concerns about whether all the ports in the world in the short run will act in the same way. It will, for sure, take some time before a consensus is reached, predefined pattern or patterns of operations. This is especially challenging when many of the world's ports lack suitably responsive governance structures. One solution might not fit all, since ports are not all managed the same way. Nevertheless, port call optimization, from a port's point of view, aims to provide enhanced predictability on when visiting ships can be served and when they will be ready to depart from the port. This includes the coordination with the various government and service sectors, who all have roles in relation to the vessel's arrival, such as customs and immigration, ship's handlers, husbandry agents, crew change, doctor appointments, etc., as well as acknowledging the service level agreements between carriers and terminals. To do this, a fundamental level of standardization is essential. A complementary approach not taking a particular port governance model into consideration, is to adopt a principle where actors continually align their plans based on common situational awareness constituted by each of the actors. The principle is followed within port collaborative decision making, port CDM. Possible combinations. Many of the initiatives with digital implications currently being taken by the community of port call optimizers are both promising and reusable from a ship-centric perspective, including a shared understanding of the definitions of core events, timestamps, and nomenclature associated to the port call process, a shared understanding of a standardized messaging format such as IHO S211, standardized interfaces for messaging, a digital infrastructure that allows episodic visitors to connect to the port authorities and terminal operators, and a joint agreement on the tolerance for deviation from 100% predictability for some key events in the port call process. Most likely, existing port-centric approaches to the port call optimization will not provide all the desired effects for shipping as a whole. How technology is helping ports optimize their operations? The ports industry is facing a range of emerging challenges, including growing freight traffic, increasing pressure to address environmental concerns, operational challenges, and last but not least, the ongoing pandemic-induced disruption. To overcome these challenges, port operators are increasingly turning to technology. According to a new report by KPMG, 6 different technologies are emerging as key enablers of more efficient operations and insight. Internet of Things, IoT, can be considered the cornerstone of the broader technology transformation due to the clear need to digitize the delivery process for monitoring cargo and deliveries with the aid of smart sensors. The Port of Hamburg, the third busiest port in Europe, initiated a strategic program in 2011 to evolve into a smart port to optimize capacity and maximize efficiency. This was achieved through the adoption of IoT technology in the port ecosystem by installing sensors to monitor the use of physical assets such as trucks, cranes, carriers, loads, warehouses, etc., using GPS and geo-referencing to monitor movements of traffic. Blockchain technology has the potential to digitalize supply chains, eliminate record-keeping efforts, promote paperless transactions, and streamline the supply chains by enabling real-time communication. In 2017, the Port of Antwerp announced a pilot project for more efficient and secure container handling leveraging blockchain technology in collaboration with Nexport. The data utility platform being developed will collect and pool data from various stages in the supply chain of the Port of Antwerp. Drones are quickly becoming a regular tool in the ports and logistics industry. Ports are using drones in their routine monitoring to improve safety, reduce cost, and enhance process efficiency. Around the world, from the Netherlands to Vietnam, ports are using air robotics drones for controlling aerial cargo transport, monitoring ships, cleaning the local environment, and tracking the construction of ports. High bay storage, HBS system is an automated container handling system that stacks containers up to 11 floors high, delivering more than 3 times the capacity of a conventional yard with enhanced performance, including significant gain in handling speed, energy efficiency, safety, and reduced operating cost. Data and analytics applications are allowing supply chains to adopt a proactive rather than reactive response to supply chain risks. Singapore's Maritime and Port Authority established a data-enabled traffic prediction tool to forecast the vessel arrival times and estimate the potential traffic congestion using predictive analytics. The Port of Hamburg in Germany uses analytics to aggregate various data points, for example, vessel positions, height, and width of bridges, etc., to optimize internal port operations. Additionally, smart ports are leveraging other technologies such as artificial intelligence to enhance predictive insights and cloud computing, data management, and data sharing amongst the various stakeholders. Robotic process automation, RPA, is being leveraged to automate processes across several support functions, such as finance, human resources, and supply chain management. Digital exchange platforms are being rapidly deployed by leading ports over the past decade. These platforms digitize the entire logistics supply chain by creating a marketplace for various subsequents of the market. Video on how Entropy is a model for port call optimization technology.
So the port of Antwerp, a lot of containers are coming in, millions of containers every year. The chance is quite big that the coffee you drink in the morning has one day passed through the port here. Port business is not anymore about moving stuff, but with the emerging technologies which are coming up. It's also how can I optimize my supply chain? How can I do that in a more sustainable way by using technology as an enabler? So the port of Antwerp is the second largest port in Europe. It's about 120 square kilometers. The result is that the port today is 6 times the size of the city. So size matters because the ships are becoming bigger and bigger and deeper. The terminals became bigger and more efficient. Already today on the seagoing ships, there is already a lot of technology present, but what didn't happen is that the overall supply chain was optimized.
The most important processes in shipping are external processes which require a lot of collaboration. So when a big ship arrives here and all the trucks come here to pick up their import containers, literally more than 100 of containers have to be transferred to the truck drivers per hour. And you have, thanks to the capabilities of blockchain, a perfect track record. So you can see who has transferred at what particular moment. This creates a kind of micro ecosystem around one container.
It's important that the goods are tracked, that they are delivered on time. Certainly in these times of e-commerce, where fast delivery is crucial, we feel the pressure from customers that we have a very predictable delivery. So to keep an eye on that, we build our digital twin, where we connected different sensors. We connected the 500 cameras in the port. We connected our pipeline information. We brought together 12 different databases with financial information, GIS information, depth information. So bring in more sensors, bring in artificial intelligence, bring in machine vision.
So in a digital twin for the port, it's most important to have all the information of the waterways available. Then of course the companies that are using our ports and the ships that are transporting the cargo across the ports. If you select a ship, we can see the last 3 hours of where that ship has been. This gives a really nice view of the depth situation, and it shows the ships in relation to the depth. By combining all these different data sources in one view, we have a super situational awareness of the whole port. I think we're ahead of many ports, and I think we're ahead of many cities as well.
One of the main drivers of success for the city of Antwerp is a collaboration between work we're doing in the city and the port. Because we know if we have a dumb city, we're never going to have a smart port. Just like the port has a digital twin for all their port operations and logistical capabilities they're running in the port, We've created a digital twin for everything happening in the city, and we're using between 1,000 and 5,000 sensors. And this type of digital twin can actually help us make better decisions within the confines of, for example, mobility, air quality, noise pollution, and so on.
I think we are, since about 10 years, in a period of exponential growth of new technologies. By using drones, for instance, we can do fast interventions. By using machine vision, we can automate the inspection of our maritime infrastructure. I think smart is, of course, it doesn't mean that all the things which were done in the past were kind of dumb, but I think smart means that more technology is coming.
Shipping is a very old technology. Shipping was, and I stress the word, was certainly very conservative. A new generation of people who come now, people who have been raised with IT technologies, and they understand this is an opportunity for them.
I always say the port business is kind of untapped potential. I think we are just on the start of that, of bringing new technology into the business. And there's a huge potential.
Spotlight on the ship port interface guide. Although challenges still remain and the shift in market trends mean ports need to adapt in order to provide the best services to clients. Through the sharing of data on the supply chain route, it was also highlighted that the more information ports have to access, the more efficient a route can be, with timings justified for vessels so they are not idling at ports for long periods, for instance. More and more ports are developing high-quality digital services themselves. A logical next step is to get the best services industry-wide adopted instead of every port inventing the wheel itself. Ports' successes on their digital journeys relies on the industry's willingness to collaborate. IMO recently developed and released the Ship Port Interface Guide, which focused on 8 practical measures which can support GHG emission reduction at the ship port interface. This guide is a particularly useful document for ship owners, ship operators, charterers, ship agents, ship brokers, port authorities, terminals, and nautical service providers, and other relevant stakeholders who play an integral role in implementing the necessary changes and facilitating the uptake of emission reduction measures in the ship port interface. The measures suggested in the guide include, first, facilitate immobilization in ports. Implementation of this measure would allow for maintenance and repairs of the main engine to occur simultaneously with cargo operations. This would contribute to a reduction in GHG emissions, as it would optimize the time spent in port, therefore eliminating the need for the ship to transit to another location for work to be undertaken. Second, facilitate the hull and the propeller cleaning in ports. Implementation of this measure would allow hull and propeller cleaning to take place in port, ideally simultaneously with cargo operations. This would contribute to a reduction in GHG emissions, as it would optimize the time spent in port and eliminate the need for the ship to transit to another location for hull and propeller cleaning to be performed, as well as the reduced GHG emissions as a result of the hull and propeller cleaning itself. 3. Facilitate simultaneous operations in ports. Implementation of this measure would allow operations to occur simultaneously, such as cargo, bunkering, provisioning, tank cleaning, etc. This would contribute to a reduction in GHG emissions, as it would optimize the time spent in port, as operations can be concluded in parallel rather than in sequence. 4. Optimize port stay by pre-clearance. This measure optimizes the port call and aims to eliminate unnecessary waiting time by facilitating all required clearances in advance, thereby contributing to a reduction in GHG emissions through the optimized port stay. Ships may experience operational delays on arrival, during port operations, or at departure due to clearance processes in ports. The delays may need to be recovered in transit, often resulting in higher transit speeds and thereby increased fuel consumption and emissions. Port stay optimization can be supported by introducing pre-clearance of customs, immigration, port health, or port authority formalities, avoiding waiting time to arrive during operations alongside or to depart, in line with standard of the FAR Convention. Improve planning of ships calling at multiple berths in one port. These measures aim to improve the planning of ships calling at multiple berths in one port, as is often the case with container feeder ships, chemical, and parcel tankers. These measures aim to ensure just-in-time shifting of ships between berths and the optimization of cargo operations. Addressing the planning would result in lower GHG emissions. As the ship's time on the engine in port, the terminal operations, as well as all services ordered, such as nautical service providers, are aligned, which result in improved port turnaround times and present an opportunity for bunker savings in a subsequent voyage to the next port of call, thereby contributing to a reduction of GHG emissions. 6. Improve ship berth compatibility through improved port master data. This measure involves improving port master data to ensure that the right ship size is utilized by reliable identification of the terminal and berth, and reliable maximum length and beam per berth. Having the right ship size utilized results in lower GHG emissions per carried ton of cargo. 7. Enable ship deadweight optimization through improved port master data. This measure involves improving port master data, depths, water density, tidal heights, to enable optimization of the draught of the ship, eliminating unnecessary allowances and additional buffers in the underkill clearance. Improved access to reliable and up-to-date port master data allows for better optimization of the deadweight capacity and therefore contributes to a reduction in GHG emissions per cargo ton transported. Optimize speed between ports. This measure would allow for ships to optimize speed between ports to arrive just in time when the berths, fairway, and the nautical service are all available. This just-in-time arrival concept will improve the port call process and ultimately reduce GHG emissions. Through the application of JIT arrival, GHG emissions and air pollutants can be reduced in a twofold manner. For the ship voyage, through the optimization of the sailing speed and hence more optimal engine efficiency resulting in lower fuel consumption, and for the port area, as a number of time ships maneuvering in the approaches or waiting at anchorage is reduced. Just-in-time standards for main port call activities. Digital Container Shipping Association, a neutral non-profit group established to further digitalization of container shipping technology standards, in conjunction with its 9 member carriers, today published interface standards and messaging API specifications for all 50 event timestamps defined in its port call data definitions, which address the 6 main parts of a port call: berth arrival planning, pilot boarding place arrival and service planning, pilot boarding place and berth arrival execution, start cargo operations and services, services and port departure planning, port departure execution. The interface standards allow carriers, ports, terminals, and other service providers involved in a port call to exchange event data in a uniform way, enabling automated data exchange. The complete framework of just-in-time port call standards supports digital port call planning, increased operational efficiency, and optimal resource utilization. It is the next major milestone in the effort to achieve a more transparent vessel voyage ecosystem following the 2020 publication of DCSA standards for operational vessel schedules, which enable automatic sharing of schedule information between vessel operators and their partners. By moving container shipping towards a more efficient port call process, DCSA standards enable container ships to optimize their steaming speed, thereby lowering fuel consumption and reducing greenhouse gas emissions. To provide a global industry framework that preserves investments, DCSA collaborated with ITPCO and to align port call data definitions to existing standards. The standards are being tested by carriers, ports, and terminal operators at multiple ports around the world. These tests will help DCSA ensure its standards address the needs of stakeholders. Achieving just-in-time port calls requires accurate, real-time communication between carriers, ports, and terminals. DCSA digital standards are key to enabling this level of communication on a global scale. Customers of shipping services want visibility and predictability. Having a complete set of standards for port calls is an important step towards improving the efficiency and the accuracy of data exchange between all parties. The port call is the perfect way to showcase how critical it is to have an interoperable technology framework that enables seamless communication and cross-stakeholders collaboration. By adopting DCSA standards for just-in-time port calls, operational vessel schedules, and the track and trace, the industry will see an emerging digital ecosystem where these activities turn into collaborative, data-driven digital processes. Carriers, ports, terminals, service providers, and customers of container shipping alike will gain efficiency, cargo visibility, and cost savings. Digitalization also improves sustainability through better communication and planning, thereby reducing fuel consumption, greenhouse gas emissions, and paper waste. Just-in-time arrivals will revolutionize how port calls are organized. But it is only the first step in the transformation as more port stakeholder systems deploy artificial intelligence. Just-in-time arrivals have become a hot topic as port, terminals, and ship operators awaken to the advantages of reduced fuel consumption and optimized resource planning. The benefits are clear. A study by DNVGL in 2018 found that ships spend roughly 37 to 54% of their time and 15% of their fuel in berth or at anchor. Reducing time spent waiting for a port slot and speeding up port calls would cut fuel use and emissions, while improving fleet and port utilization. What started as an analog process, one man, one fish, two monitors, and a subscription to an AIS tracking service has become increasingly digital. Instead of having to continuously re-entering AIS numbers to monitor vessels, port call optimization software now tracks vessels automatically, cross-referencing data from carriers, terminals, and weather services to provide accurate predicted arrival times. Updated plans for entering the port, initially conveyed to vessels operators or agents by telephone, have developed into a digitally delivered passage plan document. The emailed passage plan is an improvement, but not a perfect solution. You send something by email to a carrier, and then potentially you don't hear anything. Did they agree to the recommended time of arrival? Did they forward it to the crew? We have to check that vessel is really doing what we suggested. The next stage of development is conveying the passage plan directly into ship's navigational systems to link ships connected ACTIs, their operators' shoreside systems. The same solution could be used to convey and automatically update the passage plan between a ship, ports, and terminals. The benefit here is that we are always on the same page. We know if the carrier, the crew, and the terminal know what we have recommended, and we receive constant status updates, for example, that the carrier has agreed to the RTA and that the captain has applied this in the waypoints that he has to cross. While just-in-time arrivals are seen as a critical area for improving port efficiency, it is only the low-hanging fruit of what distillation can offer ports. As an example, the algorithms that learn to provide increasingly accurate arrival time estimates, and the grounding and collision detection and the avoidance capability of artificial intelligence technology. AI track predictor technology collects and analyzes information on vessel movements, then forms predictions based on typical vessel behavior, as well as offering accurate ETA information and sending collision avoidance alerts. This system can even suggest collective actions to ships in contact with the VTS center. Reaching this level of integration is not a simple undertaking. Some ports, Hamburg for example, have integrated such systems already. But to improve the efficiency of the logistics system as a whole, a network of ports will need to adopt a similar approach. And ports across the world are very different in their approach to planning port calls and coordinating with stakeholders. The pace of port digitalization can seem frustratingly slow, given the huge benefits of a more efficient international logistics network. But I am optimistic that digitalization will continue to accelerate, driven by increasing competition and the growing focus on environmental protection, which itself encourages efficient port practices. Optimizing resources will be a key driver. Digital processes will replace existing ones. For many ports, there is still a long digitalization path ahead. And even for those that seem to be leading the pack, are only scratching the surface of what smart port system will be able to offer. When it comes to the use of AI in port system, just-in-time arrivals are just the beginning. Growing sustainable ports through digitalization. Seaports of today have undergone substantial changes several times, moving from being a simple gateway to seaborne transport and inland waterways, supporting local industry for goods import and export, to becoming arenas of business activity. In support of their traditional roles as gateways for goods and passengers, ports now have the possibility to be digital, energy and information nodes. And to do it all in a substantial manner, all empowered by digitalization and the sharing of relevant information via data streams. A key question then becomes, How do the ports arrange their digital infrastructures to provide the expected or targeted beneficial outcomes? Ports are all at different starting positions and will want to adopt different degrees of digitalization. At many smaller ports, much of the information is not managed by digital means. Some ports have taken pioneering steps to become first movers in the adoption of advanced technologies for collaboration, synchronization, automation, and analytics. But for most ports, digitalization skills are only a small part of their capability set. Few smaller and medium-sized ports can run larger digitalization projects themselves. However, there is movement towards companies providing simplified and less complex solutions for specific use cases. Ports can also pull together and share development costs. Based on the experience of well-developed ports, a digital three-step maturity model has been developed that accommodates the different situation for individual ports. The maturity model takes a formal digitalization strategic plan as the basis for informing actions on subsequent steps. The first step is achieved with a digitally connected infrastructure. And the second is the achievement of digital collaboration, both steps between the port actors as well as becoming established as a communication party to the outside world. The final step is to have in place defined services and business models for digital business activity. What is a smart port? A smart port is a port that uses automation and innovative technologies, including artificial intelligence, big data, Internet of Things, and blockchain to improve its performance. Although the industry of ports and container shipping is often regarded as conservative and resistant to change, there are new technologies, systems, and solutions emerging that will alter this perception in the coming years, leading the entire sector to a brighter, more connected future. The need to evolve and become smart is even more paramount today with the changing demands of global trade. Ships are getting bigger, goods are moving faster, and the geopolitical issues are creating new challenges for ports and all around the world. The industry has already embraced many emerging technologies such as digital twins, cargo flow optimization, and visualization, giving customers end-to-end transparency of their cargo's journey through the supply and the emergence of 5G's low latency and faster connectivity to improve port operations. The digitalization of industrial processes is turning the way we produce goods and services upside down as we look for higher efficiencies and better management of resources. This transformation is the so-called Industry 4.0, and the Internet of Things can be considered its cornerstone. Due to the clear need to capture information from all industrial assets, the maritime sector is not an exception in this transformation, and the changes are starting to accelerate. The port of Esbjerg, for example, is leveraging a digital twin data visualization platform to identify, monitor, and analyze the emissions outputs of not just its own carbon consumption, but eventually all actors using the port's facility. The digitalization and measuring of the port's assets has allowed the port to make significant strides in reducing its carbon output within the port community. But digitalization is still a largely untapped resource in ports. Reports found in February 2021 that of these 4,900 ports around the world, a staggering 80% continue to rely on legacy and paper-based processes to manage maritime services. ports aiming to become smarter must complement their physical operations with digital processes. What is a smart port? As technology develops and the global supply chain becomes increasingly digital, there is a necessity for ports to become a digital node within that infrastructure. In this respect, the exponential growth of digital technology is placing pressure on the port sector to adopt it. Those who fail to do so could be left behind. The benefits of adopting a dual approach that encompasses both the physical and the digital are considerable, especially for the testing and the optimization of a physical infrastructure. Building a key wall, for instance, without the support of digital twin technology and predictive analysis could be very costly, whereas testing the structure's functionality before it is constructed offers a much clearer insight as to what impact a major investment like this could have. Money saved through digitalization can be used elsewhere to fund key maintenance and infrastructure projects, allowing the port to hone its focus on improving the efficiency of its operations. What are smart port technologies? With passing time, nearly everything in this rapidly changing world is getting under the algorithms of interminable data. From health infrastructure, which became more prominent during the recent menacing pandemic, to all strata of business, the list is increasing every day. Ports are no exception. With burgeoning trade routes and traffic, great exchange of goods and products, strategic development between nations, and the insatiable demand of the ever-increasing population, the ports and terminals are getting increasingly busy hubs. This implies greater manpower, more overheads, more space, and acquisitions, quality infrastructure, lesser downtime, and most importantly, greater efficacy. While most can be materialized with higher revenues and a strengthening business, the pressure on these places to meet increasing expectations needs to be eased, at the same time, not compromising on the efficiency and the quality standards. This is where automation and data come into play. Smart ports are essential infrastructure that uses automation, integration of services, digitization, and data-driven techniques for functioning as ports dedicated for management of cargo, mainly using technologies, such as the Internet of Things, big data, blockchain technologies, augmented reality, and other smart and data science-based interfaces. The name smart itself implies the capabilities of the port and the integrated workflow. With the ever-increasing maritime traffic, greater frequency of cargo loading, unloading, more number of vessels operating in a given trade route, and the movement of multifarious cargo, the practices in smart ports are essential for increased manpower, management, controls, and paraphernalia. Smart ports, peers of future. We'll be right back. implementing a smart port, though this is a burning question, the success stories of multiplayers of them can provide models to idealize on. So the first and foremost step is obviously the funds. Big players in the maritime trade have been extensively investing in convergence to smart ports for more holistic business process and to garner higher returns, needless to say, expanding portfolios for markets. After the proper allocation of funds, planning is crucial. Strategizing. Nothing is feasible without a strategy. So, drawing a strategy that maximizes returns, attracts investment, and restricts plausible risk needs to be there. Identification of risk. This is a very crucial and sensitive step. No business should be proceeded without identifying the risks ranging from market to operations. This yields a proper plan for the smart port to be capable of eradicating the risk and working on the so-called pain points. After the last step, analyzing all the business solutions under the proposed blueprint. Developing innovative cases. Land acquisition for new buildings and expansions, if required, with full negotiation. Visualizing and materializing the layout of infrastructure and systems, optimizing space, ease of workflow, risk, costing, etc. Acquiring adequate manpower and equipment. Reaching out to sustainable development with balance at all levels. Assessing feasibilities for collaboration and cooperation with other parts of or infrastructure. Something very typical of emerging smart ports for broader perspective of business and once again, sustainable development. This opens unexplored avenues for greater data pools, sharing and generating insights for emboldening business partnerships. Environment. Last but not the least, this is a part and parcel of everything. A port, however, may it satisfy everything discussed so far, is not smart if it is not environment friendly. A foremost criterion of smart ports is minimal emission. So, along with implementing all of the actions, the requirement for minimizing emissions, optimizing energy efficiency, and avoiding and cutting all forms of spillage and dispositions must be thoroughly met. If smart ports are considered the future, then the future is already here. This is another revolution in the realm of the maritime industry, which can only when all ports go smarter and greener, notwithstanding the enormous and ever-increasing boom in the world freight and traffic, which has successfully weathered all obstacles, the latest being the raging coronavirus pandemic, where for a significant span of time, perhaps only ships were the only moving things in a deadlocked world. We are already looking at 2050 from Port of Rotterdam.
Ports should invest in digital solutions because it's where this industry is going, and the beauty of it is that we're a lagging industry. So we have fine examples of what a digital change can mean for one industry. We've seen it in media, you've seen it in the obvious of the hotel branch and such. So what does that mean for a logistics industry? The impacts could be huge. So as a port, you are a node within a supply chain, and I'm a firm believer that in order to be able to have the same function you have now, being the node in a physical infrastructure, you have to be a node in the digital infrastructure as well. So in order to be a port authority and have the authority and the ability to execute that authority, you need to be digital. For us, smart port means that next to the physical port that we are, we will also be a digital port. So that would mean that any key wall we are building today has a digital twin. And the digital twin enables us to do predictive maintenance, to do predictive berthing, to do all sorts of other stuff that you can't do with just a physical key wall. So that's one part of the digitization. And that means that we can save money on our dredging, on our maintenance, on the patrol boats. It's really an efficiency of the port authority as an organization itself. And on the other hand, we see that in future, we will have to receive autonomous sailing vessels. So in order to receive them, we also have to be able to communicate with a vessel that doesn't have people on board. So that incentivizes the need to go digital and be smart port. And the other part of our smart port concept is that we see a disintermediation going on within our industry. So the platforms are not huge, but you can already book a container via Alibaba. You see that Damco is doing a platform booking site. You see Flexport, you see Twill, Turvo, GoHoPort, you see TradeLens and IBM. You see all sort of platforms popping up, and those are there to stay. They might not all survive, but there will be platforms in future. And in order for a port authority to communicate with those platforms, you need to be a smart and digital port.
Automation plays a catalytic role for smart ports. Another major factor in driving the urge towards smart port technologies is the requirement for automation. With more business processes to be adhered to, they require manifold painful work than ever before. Furthermore, with greater interconnection with more stakeholders, the contribution for holistic, broader trade demands more aspects of the operation. And in the maritime industry, as we all know, time is money. All the scenarios need to be catered to in leisure downtime without fail. This is where automation plays a catalytic role. Robotics, computerized algorithms for workflow, computer-aided management of freight saving in easing the struggling of conventional methods. Crane lays and cargo loading and unloading transportation systems are being extensively used in the realm of automation. Automatic guided vehicles are mobility systems with full automation in the form of smart sensors, laser detection, and encoders. These help in the proper management of cargo during the loading, offloading process, and the transportation at suitable places based on intelligent algorithms for space allocation, safe storage and marshalling, optimizing space, safety constraints, and cargo type. Smart ships and containers are also being hugely used, which helps in the integration of oncoming vessels and the port, streamlining traffic and optimizing the efficacy of operations. Other multifarious kinds of automation include gates for entry and closure based on requirement, and compliance of security based on modern artificial intelligence and identification methods, biometrics, etc. Motion-based illumination system based on requirement and the interport traffic and cargo handling. This accentuates the excess wastage of energy when a particular area is dormant or particular burst of queue is idle or disused. Smart warning and fully automated extinguisher systems during emergencies like fires, attacks, or natural disasters. Automatic systems for cleansing, maintenance, sewage, drainage, etc. Often for the health of manpower. Automated systems for disinfectants or sanitization is employed by these new generation ports. Now the importance manifold in times of a global pandemic. So smart ports are essentially digital and interconnected infrastructure that addresses every aspect of a conventional one in terms of connectivity and communication, automation, integration, and data. So it goes without saying that machine learning and artificial intelligence are basically related to all of these. Training systems with data can lead to more automation and accurate execution of processes in negligible time. 광양 port goes for smart port.
부산항에 이어 물동량 처리 2위를 기록하고 있는 광양항이 세계적인 항만으로 도약할 기회를 맞았습니다. 국내에선 처음으로 물류 운송 전 과정을 자동화하는 스마트 항만 구축 사업이 본격적으로 시작됐습니다. 박승현 기자가 취재했습니다.
크레인 조종사들이 선박에서 컨테이너 화물을 내리는 데 한창입니다. 앞으로는 25m 높이에서 하루 8시간 동안 일하는 조종사가 사라지고 크레인이 자동으로 화물을 올리고 내릴 수 있게 됩니다. 국내에서는 처음으로 광양항 전 영역을 완전 자동화하는 사업이 올해부터 추진됩니다.
올해부터 2026년까지 약 7천억 원이 투입되어서 컨테이너 수송부터 선박의 수송까지 모든 것을 자동화하는 사업이 되겠습니다.
개항 24년이 된 광양항의 물동량 정체가 갈수록 심해지면서 새로운 돌파구로 스마트 항만을 선택했습니다. 선박과 화물, 장비, 작업자를 인터넷으로 연결하고 물류 처리를 완전 자동화해 생산성을 크게 높인다는 계획입니다.
장기적으로는 수소 공임항 구축 등을 통해서 광양항을 탄소 중립 정책에 부합하는 그러한 친환경 항만으로 거듭날 수 있도록 적극 지원할 계획입니다.
2026년부터 무인 자동화 시스템을 운영할 광양항. 세계적인 항만인 네덜란드 노트르담과 미국 롱비치와도 어깨를 나란히 할 날이 머지 않았습니다. KBC 박승현입니다.
부산 포트 어소리티.
부산 항만공사가 항만의 완전 자동화를 목표로 첨단 항만 시설 장비 제작에 본격적으로 나섰습니다. 탄소 중립을 위한 장비 연료 시스템도 친환경으로 전환하면서 스마트 항만으로의 변화에 속도를 내고 있습니다. 보도에 이희슬 기자입니다.
조종사 없이 원격으로 움직이는 안벽 작업용 컨테이너 크레인. 신항 7부두가 될 서 컨테이너 터미널이 도입되는 우리 기술로 만들어진 최초의 국산 장비입니다. 현대중공업 계열사인 현대인프라솔루션이 제작 중인데 안벽용 크레인으로는 국내에서 처음 선보이는 최대 규모의 자동화 장비입니다.
그리고 세계적으로 이제 선박 자체가 대형화되다 보니까는 22,000 TEU를 처리할 수 있는 그런 크레인은 현존 우리나라에서는 아직까지 없습니다. 그래서 이제 이 크레인은 22,000 TEU를 대상으로도 충분히 처리할 수 있는 그런 규모를 가지고 있습니다.
이 안벽 크레인을 포함해 야적장 작업용 크레인도 완전 자동화에 맞춰 제작됩니다. 현재 신항 1부두에서부터 6부두에 설치된 하역 장비의 90% 상당은 외국산. 특히 안벽 작업용 크레인은 국산 설치율이 0%입니다. 이를 100% 국산화로 제작한다는 게 목표입니다. 나아가 이송 작업용 장비도 현재의 디젤 연료 기반에서 전기 배터리로 전환해 탄소 중립형 항만 조성에 나섭니다. 다만 항만 자동화에 따른 항만 노동자들의 일자리 전환 문제는 정책적으로 풀어야 할 숙제입니다.
이제는 항만 공간을 단순하게 하역하는 공간이 아니라 물류와 제조까지 결합하는 공간으로 만들어 놓게 되면 기존의 항만에서 일하는 사람들이 제조나 물류에서 같이 일할 수 있는 일자리가 또 추가적으로 생겨나는 거죠.
외국 선진 항만들에 비해 스마트 전환이 더디다는 지적을 받는 부산항. 자동화와 친환경화를 통해 고부가가치 항만으로 거듭나는 데 속도를 내고 있습니다. K KBS 뉴스 이희슬입니다.
글로벌 케이스. The German Federal Ministry of Digital and Transport will fund the construction of a digital test bed at the port of Hamburg with just under 15 million euros. The new terminal in Tianjin includes an automated twist lock handling station that spans over a travel lane. AGVs drive into the station where the twist locks are handled by robotic arms. A new digital berth planner tool to optimize allocation of berths at the port of Gothenburg has gone live, a key step in the ongoing digitalization of the port as a freight hub. As the world's first all-electronic zero-emission mega-terminal, Long Beach Container Terminal sets the industry standard for moving cargo sustainably while keeping the port competitive and supporting vital jobs. Singapore has launched plans for new common data infrastructure to support digital data sharing between supply chain ecosystems, both locally and globally, through a public-private partnership involving maritime stakeholders including PSA International Jurong Port, Ocean Network Express, and the Pacific International Lines. Global cases too. British Telecom and associated British Port of Ipswich will deploy BT's intelligent asset platform across the port estate. China's Baibu Gulf Port Group is to implement a terminal operating system from Korean company CyberLogitech at its new Ginzhou Greenfield Terminal, featuring a range of new technologies to handle automated operations. Russian container terminal operator Global Ports is to implement an AI-powered bus optimization engine from PortChain to optimize bus allocation and allow customers to monitor data on vessel status in real time. The new system will be used to improve the allocation of berths at First Container Terminal and Petrolis Port in the Greater Port of St. Petersburg. Tanzimat, the largest Mediterranean and African container port, has partnered with Bacila to jointly develop a new port management information system, which aims to facilitate increased levels of data exchange and improve operational efficiency, port safety, and environmental sustainability. Eon Geophysical Corporation has announced that its climate smart digital platform, Marine Smart Port, has successfully fulfilled its role in helping monitor greenhouse gas emissions in the data-led emissions management project. MPA has announced it has successfully tested an autonomous queue crane as well as autonomous terminal tractors in Singapore. Wilson Sons, a port and maritime logistics operator in Brazil, acquired a minority equity participation at DocTech. The deal also regards a commercial exclusivity agreement to install digital twin technology throughout Brazilian ports. Costco Shipping Ports Spain, Valencia Terminal is to build a digital twin of its terminal facility to support improved decision-making in daily operations and to optimize processes and use of equipment. The Port of Helsinki is doing its part in the world's common efforts to combat climate change, bringing forward the targets for emissions reduction to 2030. Last but not the least, the ports of Montreal, Quebec City, and Trois-Rivières share 250 kilometers of waterway, serve interconnected economic and social ecosystems, and have complementary intermodal platforms.